Welcome back to Time to Football. Today's review is going to be on one of the most anticipated helmets of 2014. This is the new Zenith Epic. You guys saw the unboxing a couple weeks ago, so I know you guys have been dying for this review. So I had a chance to test it out for a couple weeks in practice. And as you can see, it's all decaled up. You know, I use it with my team. It's got a visor on it now. So I'm going to go into an in-depth review, obviously giving you the things I always cover off on in helmets. Talking about the weight, the comfort, the protection, the ease of cleaning, as well as the price and where you can get it. And of course, you guys know that I have a Zenith X2E, so I will tell you guys some of the differences between the two before I get into the detailed review. So this is gonna be a little difficult for me to show you guys that I have two helmets here, but as you can see on your right side, I've got the Zenith Epic, and on your left side, I've got the X2E. So at first glance, they probably look really similar. They both have the new style face mask on there, as you can see. But first, we're gonna start with the shell. You can see at the top the vents. On the X2E, you've got the rear vents at the back, kind of looks like the Revolution helmet. You've got those six vents at the back. On the Epic, however, you've got the vents at the front of the helmet, and then you've also got the vents at the back that kind of form an X, like Zenith. So this one is supposed to be a lot more cooling, supposed to have special vents, they call it. So it does have increased airflow in the helmet. That's one of the overall differences of the shell. I would also say that the shell design is just a little bit more updated, a little bit more modern. If you take a look at the bottom here, you can tell how it has, this little panel around it, just a little more updated look, whereas the X2E doesn't have that. It's more flat. So just a little bit more contoured, again, a little bit more of a design on the Epic. Now the biggest difference between these two helmets is going to be on the inside in terms of the protection. So again, first we're going to take a look at the X2E, just so you get a base level of what it is. And again, I'll go into the differences between even the X2. So let's take a look at this helmet. At first glance, this looks similar to the X2, but one of the differences with the X2E is that it has two-stage shock absorbers. That means that depending on where the shock absorber is placed in the helmet, they're going to be different lengths. So that's going to provide a little bit more additional protection than the original X2. There it is for you again. You can see that it has these circle comfort pads on there that come out. They can also be adjusted. And then look at the shock absorber here. So see how it's flat? So this is one stage here, and if you look on the inside, I can't remember exactly where, but this is going to be a different size shock absorber, a different length. What Zenith went ahead and did in the Epic is they actually have multi-stage shock absorbers all the way around. So first, we're going to take a look at the comfort pads, and I know it's black, so it's a little difficult to see, but these are more hexagonal, so they're the same comfort. You have the same comfort when you put it on from a padding standpoint here. But then when you look at the pads, or the shock absorbers, you can actually tell that instead of being solid, you can see you have multi-stage. You've got one in the middle, and you've got one here. So you have multi-stage shock absorption throughout the entire helmet, which is all new again for the Epic. That's going to give you the most advanced protection in any of the Zenith helmets. The other part about it is this occipital liner that they have at the back of the helmet. This is something that all the new helmets are coming with. So again, taking a look at the X2E, it doesn't have that. You see you have this full rubber part that goes across the back of your head, whereas this one has, you know, kind of these two shock absorbers. So this is going to provide a better fit as well as enhanced protection over the X2E. So besides what I just went over, there's not really other differences between the X2E. This face mask, again, is one of the newest ones. So they have three. They have the Prowl, the Pursuit, and the Prime face mask. This is the Prime, but all of the traditional Zenith face masks fit on here, both the carbon steel and the titanium. Titanium is gonna be a lot lighter for you, so it's even gonna make this already light helmet even lighter. So if you like some of those traditional face masks, you still, you know, can get a Zenith helmet and get one of those for it. So now let's talk about the weight of the helmet. When I put this helmet on, I felt like the weight was the same as the X2E. So I'm going to go ahead and give it the same rating, which is an 8. Again, if you want to compare it to another helmet, you can go on those reviews and you can check out what I rated that helmet in weight. But it is very light, and with a titanium face mask, it'll be even lighter. The protection on this helmet was excellent. Again, you already know if you saw my X2E review, I love that helmet. That helmet got a high rating as well. But with the additional features in this helmet, you got even more protection attributes with it, right? You have that occipital liner, you have the multi-stage shock absorbers throughout the helmet, and you just get a little bit more protection. So you have the same hard cup chin strap as you do on the other helmets. You have the same fitment, which again, having a very snug and fit helmet is gonna protect you the most. So I gave this helmet a 9.5 out of 10 for protection. One of the last ratings I give to helmets is just the ease of everyday cleaning. So you guys have seen my videos on how to take apart different helmets, but the rating for everyday cleaning is just, you know, when you take your helmet off, how easy is it to clean, right? So in terms of everyday, this, again, you just wipe it down. This is easy. You can take a look at the inside. All of these pads right here are vinyl. And so you can really just take a cloth or a disinfectant and wipe it down. You know, you can take a paper towel or you can take a disinfectant wipe and just wipe it down, clean your helmet, and be ready to go for the next practice. If you did want to do a deeper cleaning, you know, you would have to take some of this apart where, just like any other helmet, you're actually going to have to unscrew some things, take it apart, and clean it all out. But in terms of everyday cleaning, it's one of the easiest again, so this gets a 9 out of 10. Now, something that's more difficult to handle on this helmet is going to be the price. It's one of the more expensive helmets out there. It's definitely the most expensive in the Zenith line. It is on the Zenith website, $299. I think you might be able to find it for cheaper on some different websites. But when I did a Google search, it was mostly $299 as well. But I do think in terms of the other high-end helmets from other manufacturers, like you look at the 360, how much that costs. You look at the Vengeance, how much that costs. I think $299 is right in that ballpark, but that is what you are going to spend for this helmet. A lot of you have asked, you know, where did I get this blackout package? I have a blackout package on my Speed, meaning the bumper is black, the pads are black, you know, the rear sweatband is black, and I actually got this from Zenith, so I'm not sure if you order from a different manufacturer, or sorry, different retailer, what you might get, but I would suggest giving Zenith a call if you do like this all black look to see how you can get it. You know, I even have the black clips on here as well. My team is all black, got the black chin strap and everything. So that is my advice on that if you do want the blackout package. Now availability, obviously, you can go straight to the Zenith website and you can order it there. There's also other retailers online. You can Google those to find those as well. The last thing you guys probably want me to try this on, it is a beast looking helmet. I mean, I'm a fan of the face mask, which is why I got it. I wanted the Prime. Same thing I had on my X2E. Here you can take a look at the helmet. The visor that I have on is a 60% Oakley visor. It's not mirrored like I have on some of my other helmets, but because the inside is dark, you know, it does look a little darker, a little mirrored on the outside. But here's the front of the helmet, how it looks. You can take a look at the side as well. And you can take a look at the back. So again, this is one of my favorite helmets to wear. It is very comfortable. To adjust this helmet, you take the two chin straps and you're gonna pull it. So I'm gonna turn around so you can see the occipital pad at the back actually cinch up against my neck. So you're gonna take these and you're gonna pull. You can see where it comes down. It hugs your head. And then you're gonna snap. So there it is. Remember, if you guys like this review, remember to give me a thumbs up, share it, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.